What's up, y'all? It's Jimmy coming to you guys with another video. Today we're doing another trip to the thrift. We're going to the first spots that I did in the first video, but this time it's just gonna be me. Leilani's at work right now and I have Fridays off, so I'm gonna be taking this time to go do some thrifting. I mean, hopefully we find some good stuff. The last video I messed up and I didn't cop a lot of things I probably should have copped, so this time I'm gonna be wary with what I pick up. And you know, if there is something that I need to cop, I would definitely pick it up this time. Got my massive cores. As you guys can see, we're at Texas Thrift. So with Texas Thrift, it kind of sucks just because everything is a little bit more pricey, but I mean, they typically do have pretty good stuff, or at least this. Hopefully we find some good stuff today. For now, I'm just going through the shoes. Typically, they kind of have some good deals on the shoes as well. I'll say the best thing they have at this Texas Thrift is probably the shirts, the jackets, and the menswear. I mean, so far, I see a pair of Air Jordan 1s. Of course, they're not super hype, but look at that right there. Some little baby shoes. These are $24, so that's low-key kind of pricey for some thrifting shoes. But I mean, I see that they do have decent stuff. You just gotta be willing to dig through it and find it. Got some white Air Forces. These are $14 or $16. Like I said, a little bit pricey, but you know, condition on these ain't too bad, actually. They're size 8. I mean, I don't know how much you could really flip these for, if you even could. If you guys have been in the streetwear and skateboarding for a while, these Supra Skyvaders are a classic. Thing interesting I found is some Nike golfing shoes. I had never seen these before, so if you guys look at that. Yeah, I don't even know when these were produced, but made in Korea, so has to have been quite a while. Kind of went through the rack already. Some cool things that I found is this Old Navy button-up. Looks kind of nice. I mean, I wouldn't pick it up. It's $10, so a little bit pricey. That probably cost $10 at Old Navy. The next thing I found is this Carhartt jacket. Or not really jacket, more of a button-up, but olive. Just kind of big as hell. Price on this is $15, so like I said, Texas Thrift is not really all too cheap. Unless you find, like, maybe the t-shirts aren't too bad, but even then, sometimes you're paying like $5-6 for an old t-shirt, so it gets on the pricier side. I messed up and I should have charged my gimbal, and I'm about to struggle to record. By the time you guys see this, it might be 2021, so I mean, I hope you guys had a happy holidays. I've just been chilling. I went home down to Houston to hang out with family and my best friend Jimmy, so yeah, so it was good to take a break from work and things like that, just to go home and spend time with your loved ones. Absolutely nothing in the hoodies or the jacket so far. Probably gonna check the t-shirts and athletic gear now. Also say for a Friday, it's pretty empty. Texas Thrift, at least this one, is usually pretty jam-packed. But today, I don't know if people have work or what, but pretty low-key, pretty chill, so kind of digging this. I mean, you guys saw the last time I was here, it was crowded as hell, so. Got myself a nice little new whip. See how much this bike is. So I'm pretty sure these swim bikes are kind of expensive. This bike here, they're trying to sell for $40. So I mean, I don't know anything about bikes, but that seems a little pricey for this. This blazer real quick. Might need to cop this for a little nice little Sunday service. Get a little funky with it. This Harry Potter tee, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. This might be worth picking up. These movie tees typically do pretty well trade-wise, so might be a nice little find. So found this Astros Nike Center Swoosh tee. A little bit pricier though. It's $6, so this might be a pass just because it also is a large, and typically selling Houston stuff in Dallas is pretty difficult. I want to recap with you guys what I found. You guys saw the Harry Potter tee. Found a Center Swoosh Astros tee. Not going to be picking this up because it is $7 or $6. And maybe if it was like $2-3, I would. And the Harry Potter tee, probably going to pass on it as well. So I'm actually going to cop the Astros tee. I texted my homie Justin and he said he wanted it. So going to pick this up for him. I mean, pretty nice find. If I could fit it, I would probably cop it. But just because it's a large, I know, you know, I'm going to buy these big t-shirts and never wear them. I got the goodies cop. Total for the shirt was $6.41. And might as well show you you guys the fit. Got some 2016 white cement fours, white Nike saw casual beaters, some Nike trail short shorts, and a vintage Nike hoodie that I showed in one of my cops from the thrift video. You guys saw what I just copped from Texas Thrift. Now I'm heading to the Goodwill right down the street. It's nice because literally there's like a chain of thrift stores right by each other, so there's really not much driving that you have to do. It's the Goodwill. Gonna head on inside now. This Goodwill is kind of like a luxury Goodwill. It's a little bit more expensive than most, but I mean, I took you guys here before and didn't find much last time, so hopefully that is different this time. Just found two things that I wanted to show you guys. First one is a Clippers jersey, probably from mid-2000s because it is a Nike jersey, and I have a Yao Ming jersey that I got when I was like in middle school, so pretty sure this is like from 2005 or something, but it's Odom on the back. I don't remember Lamar Odom being on the Clippers, but that might be another Odom. Next shirt I wanted to show you guys is this Taste of Texas. It's like a rabbit show shirt. Nothing super crazy about it, but it is from 1996, so I was about a month old when they dropped this shirt. Nothing much, and I probably won't pick this up, but I'm gonna show you guys what I found at the Goodwill. I love Goodwill, and now we're in this one. It's just kind of like Texas Thrift, but that Goodwill as well. Last time I was here, I think I found a couple pretty cool jackets with Leilani, so that was the last time I was here, and that was about like 2 months ago, so hopefully they have some good stuff today. So in Family Thrift, already found some pretty cool pieces. There's like this vintage Columbia jacket. This is a size XL for $17 though, so this is a pretty cool little come up right here. And then I found this like Strooge rally t-shirt. It's like a biker rally. This is $2. So I'm just going through the t-shirts right now. Some of the t-shirts aren't too bad. They actually have a couple Harley tees, all in like XL and large though. And they're asking like 15, 12 bucks for them. So here it is, Harley Davidson 100th anniversary open road tour. The back of this is actually pretty sick. The front of it is this, and it's I think printed in 2002, so pretty dope. And then here's another one, Longmont, Colorado. The back of this one is pretty nice as well, and the front is actually pretty fire too. You guys can see they're asking for $12.91. I think thrift stores now are kind of catching on, like that people are buying stuff to sell, so they're trying to maximize all the money they can, you know. Just to give you guys an idea of the jackets they have, I found this work jacket that is actually pretty dope. It's like a Bernie brand, I guess, personalized, like Neo, TD Industries. Definitely got it from work. Then they have a couple others. Found this LL Bean that is pretty dope, asking for $17. So, and there is a varsity jacket I found that was pretty cool. This guy right here, the base of the jacket is blue and has like brown leather sleeves, pretty dope. Personalized as well, I think that's like a name. Then it's like for someone that worked at all these hotels and stuff, probably in Las Vegas. Just left Thrift Giant. I said it was a family thrift earlier, but it's actually called Thrift Giant. Didn't really find anything worth copying or like copying to resell. So, I mean, you guys saw the jackets, the t-shirts, some of it was pretty nice. Right now, I'm gonna go grab some lunch, head home, chill. I'm pretty tired. Did a whole bunch of recording this morning. Then I went thrifting. I was trying to find some dope stuff for you guys, but you ended up empty-handed besides the Astro shirt for Justin. I hope you guys enjoy the thrift to the thrift. I swear that's a tongue twister. Until next time, I'll catch you guys later. Peace. So guys, so I wasn't even planning on thrifting today, but or recording actually, but I found some crazy stuff at the thrift. I'm gonna show you guys right now. I found like 5 Carhartt jackets, a Dallas Cowboys shirt, and another vintage shirt, but all pretty sick finds. Not gonna mess up this time and gonna pick them all up, but just wanted to show you guys a quick run through of everything I found. So if you guys see, just around with the t-shirts, vintage 1993 Dallas Cowboys t-shirt, kids Carhartt jacket, a men's Carhartt jacket in this khaki color. This navy one is fire. It's like a Detroit jacket. It's another khaki one right there. And then this one is a Wrangler jean jacket. I might keep that for myself. Then the zip up Carhartt hoodie. So all super fire finds, everything is $12. Gonna be picking this all up and then showing you guys my pickups in the thrifting haul. You guys can see, copped everything for $62.79. Got like 5 Carhartt jackets, 1 Wrangler jacket, 1 Dallas Cowboys tee. I mean, super fire pickup. I'll show you guys everything here in a bit.